Vanessa. In this teacher video guide, we'll introduce you to the Mindset Learn series of lessons called Figurative Language. We'll tell you what the series of lessons is about and how it links to the curriculum. We'll also discuss ideas for using the lessons with your learners. In these lessons, we aim to help learners differentiate between literal and figurative language. We define and give examples of various figures of speech, and we help learners to see the functions that figures of speech perform in a range of contexts. After watching these lessons, your learners will be better able to identify and comment on figurative language in texts, and they will be more confident in using appropriate figurative language in their own writing and speaking. There are 8 lessons in this series. Literal and figurative meaning. Literal and figurative meanings in advertising. Figures of speech that use comparison. More figures of speech that use comparison. Sound devices. Figures of speech in action. Fun with figures of speech. More fun with figures of speech. The lessons in this series address learning outcome 2, reading and viewing, and learning outcome 4, language. They will help learners to achieve a range of assessment standards, including being able to use a range of figurative language such as idiom, idiomatic expressions, and proverbs with developing appropriateness. Recognize how word choices, imagery, and sound devices affect mood, meaning, and theme. Before the start of each lesson, we state the outcome and assessment standards that are addressed in each lesson. And in most lessons and in the lesson notes, we give the lesson outcomes for each lesson. In this series of lessons, we begin by differentiating between literal and figurative language. And then we take a closer look at groups of figures of speech, namely figures of speech that compare, sound devices, and figures of speech that are used for fun. This helps to ensure that learners learn what the figures of speech are and see examples of each type. Once learners have gained confidence in identifying and discussing figures of speech, we move on to figures of speech in action. This helps learners to develop the skills of finding and analyzing figures of speech in context. After learners have watched this series of lessons, they should be ready to watch the lessons on Getting into Poetry, which provides them with further practice in examining figures of speech used in poetry and the effect that these create. Throughout this series, we emphasize that learners should use original examples of figures of speech to improve their own writing. To encourage this, provide your learners with examples that they can discuss, preferably from other learners' work, and then encourage them to experiment in their speeches and creative writing assignments. If you are able to, you will find it useful to watch the video by yourself before you show it to your learners. This will help you to see how to incorporate the video lessons into your learning program, and you can also plan tasks, activities, and discussions to take place before, during, or after viewing the video. If you can't watch the video in advance, this teacher video guide and the print support materials will give you some suggestions for using the videos, as well as a sense of what each lesson covers. The print support materials and most of the video lessons include a task for the learners at the end of the lesson. These tasks will help to keep the learners involved in the lesson and will also enable you to assess that they are working towards the outcomes and assessment standards of the lessons. You may also want to set additional tasks or longer assignments based on the whole series, which could be used to track a learner's progress towards the outcomes. Now, let's have a more detailed look at the lessons in the series and how you can use them in your classroom. In the first two lessons, we differentiate between literal and figurative meanings, and we look for examples of these in advertising. By looking at examples taken from advertising, we show learners that they are surrounded by figurative language and use it all the time, even if they are not aware of the names of the figures of speech being used. In lessons 3 and 4, we look at the figures of speech that use comparison. In these lessons, we define and give examples of a number of figures of speech, including the metaphor, simile, personification, and apostrophe. Encourage your learners to learn one example of each figure of speech, as well as the definition. This will help them to remember the characteristics of each type of figure of speech and will provide them with a reference to compare with unfamiliar examples. In the next lesson, we learn about sound devices. The figures of speech covered in this lesson include assonance, alliteration, and onomatopoeia. You could extend these lessons by encouraging learners to think of more examples of each sound device. For example, to revise onomatopoeia, ask learners to come up with their own words to describe sounds such as those made by a tomato falling on a pavement. Lesson 6 looks at the examples of figures of speech in action. This is a useful lesson as it revises the figures of speech we have taught so far and gives further examples in context. This would be a useful lesson to show for revision purposes before exams or prior to setting an exercise that involves identifying and discussing figures of speech in texts. In the final two lessons, we have some fun with figures of speech. In these lessons, we learn about some more common figures of speech, such as puns and rhetorical questions, as well as some less common figures of speech, such as spoonerisms and malapropisms. Learners who love the English language and the interesting text that can be created by playing with the language will especially enjoy the final lesson in this series. However, less able learners may find the obscure figures of speech intimidating. We hope that you will enjoy using these lessons to encourage learners to use figures of speech and identify them in texts. For more details about these lessons, please refer to our print teacher support materials and the lesson notes for each lesson. You can find these on our website, www.mindset.co.za.